Welcome to the Lawrence Welk Show. Featuring Lawrence Welk and the Champagne Music Makers in specially selected shows for public television.
English, and I'm here in beautiful Branson, Missouri, home of the new Welk Theater and Resort. This is the Shepherd of the Hills homestead, named after Harold Bell Wright's world-famous novel about the hard-working homesteaders that had settled here in the late 1800s. He had visited them through the drought years and saw them pushed to the edge of starvation as their crops dried up and game disappeared. Their desperation and the events that shaped their lives were the heart of his book. Tourists began coming to Branson as early as 1909, looking for the original homestead. About the same time that Mr. Wright was working on his book, Lawrence Welk was born on a rocky North Dakota homestead. But his musical talent and ambition enabled him to leave the farm. Hollywood was a farming community at the turn of the century, too. But a movie studio built in 1911 changed that forever. Hollywood became an entertainment mecca that enticed everyone, including talented young Midwestern band leaders. Today, Branson, Missouri is one of the entertainment centers of the United States. But we Californians like to think of it as the great-grandchild of Hollywood.
From Hollywood, the big band sound of Lawrence Welk.
Tonight, a cavalcade of musical styles.
There's nothing like a lively polka to get the show off on the right foot. And it's only fitting that we should start this way. For many years, our band has been associated with the polka. This evening, we'll be bringing you many styles of music. First, the type of music that has been our trademark since 1938, champagne music. We invite you folks to dance. A one and two and...
Thank you.
dizzy. Raindrops keep falling on my head. Certain musical styles seem to come and go, but country music grows more popular all the time. Our talented husband and wife team, Guy and Rona, recall an all-time country favorite.
From the great Atlantic Ocean to the wide Pacific shore, she rolls along the woodland through the hills and by the shore. She's mighty tall and handsome, she's known quite well by all. She's the beau's accommodation, the Wabash Cannonball.
She came in from Birmingham one cold December day. As she pulled into the station, I heard somebody say, well, there's a gal from Tennessee, she's long and she's tall. She come down to Birmingham on the Wabash Cannonball.
Listen to the jingle, the rumble and the roar, as she rolls along the woodland, through the hills and by the shore. Hear the mighty rush of engine, hear the lonesome hobo's call, as she rolls through the jungle Wabash Cannonball.
From the great Atlantic Ocean to the wide Pacific shore, she rolls along the woodlands, through the hills and by the shore. She's mighty tall and handsome, she's known quite well by all. She's the beau's accommodation, the Wabash Cannonball. She's the beau's accommodation, the Wabash Cannonball.
It wasn't the Wabash Cannonball that brought Harold Bell Wright, a preacher and author, to Missouri in 1896. But he traveled as far into the Ozark Hills as the rails could take him, looking for a milder climate to cure his tuberculosis and his writer's block. He took shelter for the night on the homestead of John and Anna Ross and stayed until September, returning each summer for 8 years. He pitched his tent right here, looked at this beautiful view, and was inspired to pick up his pen and write The Shepherd of the Hills. The creators of The Welk Show didn't ever seem to suffer from writer's block. They came up with good ideas week after week for 29 years, ideas that are still entertaining today. This show is a tribute to all kinds of musical styles, from ragtime piano to a rousing march, from the blues to Broadway. And that's where we're headed now, The Great White Way, and one of my favorite musicals, My Fair Lady. It was written by Fritz Lowe and Alan J. Lerner and opened in New York in 1956. Julie Andrews played Eliza Doolittle, and Professor Higgins was played by Rex Harrison. Mr. Welk loved the music from the play, and he especially liked this song.
Broadway shows have their own distinctive musical style. The songs are usually a little different from the average popular song. Tom Netherton sings a song from one of the most popular musicals of all time, My Fair Lady.
I've grown accustomed to her face. She almost makes the day begin. I've grown accustomed to the tune she whistles night and noon. Her smiles, her frowns, her ups, her downs are second nature to me now. Like breathing out and breathing in, I was serenely independent and content before we met. Surely I could always be that way again, and yet I've grown accustomed to her looks, accustomed to her voice, accustomed to her face. She's second nature to me now. Like breathing out and breathing in, I'm very grateful she's a woman,
and so easy to forget. Rather like a habit, one can always break, and yet I've grown accustomed to the trace of something in the air. Accustomed
fine. In bringing you samples of different musical styles, we're very fortunate to have two people like Sis and Bobby on our show. They are experts in just about every style of dancing. Sissy, take over, please.
Bo-bo-dee-o-do and razzmatazz were expressions that came in with one of the biggest dance crazes of all time. Those were the days when the Red Hot Mamas and their big daddies were out on the floor cutting a rug with that wild dance of the Roaring Twenties, the Charleston.
In the early 1940s, the big band sounds came alive. You had Tommy Dorsey, Woody Herman, Wayne King, and of course the champagne music of a Lawrence Welk. We'd like to take you back to the 40s right now, if we may, and show you the dance style they were doing when they heard Glenn Miller play In the Mood. Here's our version of The Jitterbug. Something I borrowed from Elvis. We've tried to show you a little history of American ballroom dancing, and the reason it was so popular here in the United States is because a man and lady got to dance together, a little romance and cuddle up a little bit. Today is a different thing. Everybody does their own thing, right? The girl dances over here and the man dances over here. Now, Sissy and I love to do the new rock dances, and we entered a rock dance contest about 3.5 years ago, and we're lucky enough to win it. Sissy was in Hollywood, California. I was in Oshkosh, Wisconsin. Anyway, we'd like to show you some of the new rock and roll dance styles from the 60s right up today, if we may. And that calls for a little soul music. 1, 2, 3. You gotta know how to pony, like Boney Maroney. The mashed potato.
The alligator.
Do the jerk. Now let your backbone work. Twist with Sissy. Do the Y2C.
The
guess I was born 40 years too soon. I'll stick to the waltz and polka. I think a ballad qualifies as a style of music. Here's one of the best, a recent Academy Award winner. And to sing it, our lovely Sandy Griffiths. Bob, give her a nice introduction.
Memories light the corners of my mind. Misty watercolor memories of the way we were. Scattered pictures of the smiles we left behind. Smiles we gave to one another for the way we were. Can it be it was all so simple then? Or has time rewritten every line? If we had a chance to do it all again, tell me, would we? Could we? Memories may be beautiful, and yet what's too painful to remember?
Wrote the music for that song with lyrics by Marilyn and Alan Bergman. It was a smash hit for Barbra Streisand, both as a record and a movie. It was a billion-dollar idea putting that songwriting team and that star together, an inspired choice, so to speak. It's no accident that I'm standing in front of Inspiration Tower, built as a glorious tribute to the author of The Shepherd of the Hills, who was inspired by the unspoiled beauty of this Ozark mountain country. Writers have always looked to nature for inspiration, and Rodgers and Hammerstein were no exceptions. Their musicals were either set in exotic places like the South Pacific and Siam, for their final musical, The Sound of Music, they even remembered as a national folk anthem. The very last song they wrote together was the song you're about to hear, Edelweiss.
Blossom snow may you bloom and grow, bloom and grow forever. Edelweiss, Edelweiss, bless my homeland
pleasant, Norma and Jim. We're all very proud of this next young lady. Gail Farrell came to us from Oklahoma with a fine background in classical music. She's been working very hard to develop and expand her many talents, and she's making wonderful progress. Right now, Gail is going to give us a sample of Ragtime, playing the famous Maple Leaf Rag. Time you learn a new song and do such a good job, you get a hug from the boss.
Oh boy, good, that's nice.
Thank you very much. The blues have long been a part of American music. Tanya has a song that tells the story of the blues. She's joined by Henry Questa on clarinet.
They heard the breeze in the tree singing with melody, and they called that the start of the blues. And from a jail came the wail of a downhearted out the land.
magnificent view will chase your blues away in a second. But we didn't have too much trouble with that on the Welk Show anyway. There was always something to smile about and lots of big laughs backstage. I wasn't much older than my daughter Julie is right now when I started on the show. You can imagine how excited I was to be on national television. I still love show business, and it's lost none of its charm for me. Amazingly, even though she has parents in the business, Julie doesn't seem to be headed in that direction. But stay tuned. You know how kids are. One of the guys on the Welk Show who arrived 5 months after I did was Ken D'Lo. He was just a kid, too, and you can tell just by looking at him, he was lots of fun to be with. And we were so happy that Mr. Welk found him.
On with the show, and let's see what Ken D'Lo has for us, Ken.
Thank you, Lawrence. I have a song that seems to fit into the category of a typical show tune, the kind of song that makes you think of a Broadway opening. I'll start it out, and then we'll see what happens, so take it away.
Gee, it's all fine and dandy, sugar candy, when I've got you. Then I only see the sunny side. Even trouble has its funny side. When you're gone, sugar candy, I get lonesome, I get so blue. When you're handy, it's fine and dandy, but when you're gone, what can I do? And speaking of fine and dandy, here's a fine gentleman and a dandy dancer, Arthur Duncan. Go get him, Art.
Excellent, Arthur Duncan. Next, a sample of Latin music. And for this, we have someone very well qualified. That's right, our own little Mexican señorita, Ana Cani.
Por la Sierra Morena, vienen bajando, de ojitos negros, cielito lindo de contrabando. Por la Sierra Morena vienen bajando un par de ojitos negros, cielito lindo de contrabando. Ay, 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 canta y no llores, porque cantando se alegra, cielito lindo, los corazones. Pájaro que abandona su primer nido, regresa y ya no encuentra, cielito lindo, el bien perdido. Ese lunar que tiene, cielito lindo junto a la boca, no se lo des a nadie, cielito lindo que a mí me toca. Ay, 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 canta y no llores, porque cantando se alegra, cielito lindo, los corazones. Otra vez. Ay, 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 canta y no no llores, porque cantando se alegra cielito lindo los corazones. Eso.
Anna Connie, the great John Philip Sousa, was responsible for making the Military March one of the best-loved of all American styles of music. Here's one of his early compositions, written especially for the United States Marine Corps Band. Semper Fidelis, George Cates conducts.
George Cates and the Champagne Music Makers in March style just kind of makes the blood run a little faster. You know, I guess nothing is more typical of our American music than the folk songs created by the pioneer settlers of the West. Here's a fine example featuring Ava Barber.
Away, we're bound away.
Maybe someone will write a great song about the beautiful Branson countryside someday. It certainly deserves it. Every season is wonderful here, but fall is especially nice. Warm sunny days and cool nights giving you just a hint of the coming winter. Another sign that the season is changing is the Fall Harvest Craft Festival. Missouri has a wonderful heritage of folk arts and has gone to great lengths to preserve them. Craftspeople come from all over the state to demonstrate the making of their unique things, like this hand applique denim jacket made by Annette Biedenstein. My teenage daughter, Julie, will love it. I can just see her out on the porch reading as usual, snuggled up in this. I can't wait to give it to her. There's nothing like a good old craft show out in the country. There's also nothing like a good old country song. And the next number on the show is one of the all-time greats. As a matter of fact, it's one of the world's most performed country compositions.
Oh, please release me. Let me go. For I don't love you anymore. And to waste our lives would be a sin. So release me and let me love again. Now I have found new love, dear. And I will always want her near. Her lips are warm while yours are cold. So release me, my darling, let me go. Oh, please release me, can't you see? You'd be a fool to cling to me. And to live a lie would bring us pain. So release me and let me love again. Oh, release me and let me love again. Let me go.
Ray Harvey, fine young man with a very good voice. Boogie Woogie Piano is the typical American musical style. Our musical director, George Cates, combined this style with an operatic selection to create a tune called Carmen's Boogie. Here it is with Bob Ralston at the piano. Thank you. George Case and a great job on piano by Bob Ralston. For a sample of another musical style, we bring you a beautiful song from France. Joe Feeney is joined by our girls' chorus.
Speak to me of love and say what I'm longing to hear. Tender words of love, repeat them again, I implore you. Speak.
Singing with the Welk musical family. Group singing reminds me of the Sunday mornings I spent at church as a child in Spur, Texas. It wasn't as old as this 1901 country church, but it was just as beautiful. In the last few years, I've sung concerts in churches all across the United States, and it has been such a wonderful experience for me that I've joined forces with the Christian Artists Corporation and will be performing in even more churches in the future. At home, in a chapel in Los Angeles, I lead the congregation in singing and do three solos. All this from a girl who used to think her voice was too strong and stood out too much in church. Music has always been a big part of religious services, and it can range from classic hymns to American spirituals. Sometimes it can even have a Dixieland flavor. The next song's not a jazz-style hymn, but it was written in the jazz age, 1927.
I've always enjoyed good Dixieland music. In 1956, we hired a fine Dixieland trumpet man, George Thau. George had worked with Isom Jones, the Dorsey Brothers, and Jack Teagarden. For the past 13 years, he has been a member of our production staff. Well, we finally talked him into getting his horn out of mothballs. George joins Bob Havens and the boys to give you a sample of some fine Dixieland. Thank you. George and Phallus, very, very excellent. Folks, the most requested song on our show is a beautiful hymn, which speaks well for the musical and moral standards of our audience. We feature Ralna and all of our singers. Myron Florin conducts How Great Thou Art.
O Lord, my God, when I in awesome wonder consider all the worlds thy hands have made, I see the stars, I hear the rolling thunder, thy power throughout the universe play. Then sings my soul, my Savior God, to thee. How great thou art, how great thou art. Then sings my with shout of acclamation and take me home, what joy shall fill my heart, and I will bow in humble adoration and there proclaim my God.
Was one of Mr. Welk's favorite hymns, and he always asked me to sing it when we were out on the road. It was a big favorite of our audience, and we usually ended the first act with it, or it closed the show. I have so many good memories of that song. I sang it for over 22,000 people at the Welk Show in Madison Square Garden, and it was thrilling, thrilling to hear their reaction that night. I recorded it 3 times, and it's in my latest album called Amazing Grace, which I co-produced, a new undertaking for me. Of course, that's not the only new thing in my life. Working at the new Champagne Theater and Resort here in Branson is fabulous, and I love it. I hope you enjoyed our look at musical styles on this show, and I want you to know that our style was always simply this: a good song, a good band, and an upbeat attitude. We wanted to make you feel good and get your toes tapping. It was the Lawrence Welk Band.
What I found interesting is that, of course, my parents and my wife's parents were great fans of Lawrence Welk over a number of years. But now I have a little 3-year-old daughter who looks forward to the show.